Hi everyone, this is Marika Lamro, and this video is going to explain all about factorial notation. The factorial notation tells you how many independent variables there are in a study and how many levels each of those independent variables has. Anytime you have a study that has more than one independent variable, it will have a factorial notation. So let's look at an example. Let's say I want to know how much people enjoy concerts when the volume is loud or soft and when it's brightly lit or dimly lit. And because this study has more than one independent variable, it will have a factorial notation. And what you need to do to determine the factorial notation is you need to know how many levels each variable has. So the first variable, volume, has two levels, loud and soft. And the second variable, light, also has two levels, bright and dim. So we would say that the factorial notation for this study is a 2x2. So if I were using that in a sentence, I would say this is a 2x2 study. Now you're going to figure out the factorial notation for yourself. So here's the study, and I want you to figure out what the factorial notation is, and once you think you know, unpause the video and I will walk through explaining it. So the first thing that we need to do is figure out how many levels each variable has. So the first variable has three levels: Fu Manchu, Charlie Chaplin, and Guy Fawkes mustaches. And the second variable has two levels, whether somebody's wearing glasses or not. So we would say that this is a 3x2 study. You could also call it a 2x3 study. When you're talking about the factorial notation, it doesn't matter how you order the numbers within the factorial notation. All that matters is they're in there. So you could say it's a 3x2, or you could say it's a 2x3, and both would be correct. Here's another example. Unpause the video once you think you know the answer. So the first variable has two levels. The second variable has three levels. And the last variable has two levels. So this would be considered a 2x3x2. You could also call it a 3x2x2 or a 2x2x3. I know that may look confusing, but the point is, the same numbers are in each factorial notation, they're just ordered differently, and we don't really care how you order the numbers as long as all the correct numbers are in there. So if you said any of those three things, all of those would be correct for the factorial notation. Another one for you to practice on, unpause the video when you think you know the answer. So this would be a 4x3 study or a 3x4 study. Either one of those answers is correct. And the last example. So you could call this a 2x3x2, a 3x2x3, or a 3x3x2. Any of those answers is the correct factorial notation for this study, for this design. Okay, now we're going to go the other way. And I want you to answer these two questions. If I tell you it's a 2x3 study, how many variables are there, and how many levels does each variable have? Unpause the video when you think you know the answer. So the first variable has two levels, and the second variable has three levels. So our study, this study, has two variables. The first variable has two levels. The second variable has three levels. Here's another one that I want you to figure out how many variables there are and how many levels each variable has. Unpause the video when you think you have the answer. So the first variable has two levels, the second variable has two levels, and the last variable has three levels. So there are three variables in the study, and each variable has two levels. Another example, Each variable has 4 levels, and there are 2 variables. And the last example. There are 3 variables in the study. The first variable has 2 levels, the second variable has 4 levels, and the last variable has 3 levels. And that's everything you need to know about factorial notation. As always, if you have any questions, please feel free to email me or to come to my office hours. You can email the TA or go to the TA's office hours. You can contact another classmate. And always, of course, you can go to the tutoring center for free help on this or any other statistics or methods concepts that you would like help with.